Hi everyone, I'm Jeanette Saltis and I'm here with Ashley Pepitone. We are attorneys at Atlanta Divorce Law Group. Welcome to our Facebook Live. We are here today to talk about flat fee family law cases. This is a question that we get fairly often, especially from people calling in to find out information about the process and our firm, is do you do flat fee divorce? I really want a flat fee divorce. And I think that the reason a lot of people are asking for this is they really don't know what that means and maybe some positives and negatives of that. So I just have prepared some talking points. I think that it's important to understand that a flat fee divorce or a flat fee family law case is not the same as a flat fee that you'll see in transitional type of work. What that means is there's some types of law practice where traditionally flat fees are charged. For example, like drafting up a will or writing a contract. If an attorney, if their job is to draft a lease for a property, they know how much time they're going to spend on that. That's why it's so easy to do a flat fee. They can say, this will take an hour and a half of my time. I'm going to charge $500 or whatever that might be. In the context of litigation, it's very, very difficult to do a true flat fee in the same way that a transactional attorney will do a flat fee. And the reason is because you're not just drafting a document that will take a certain amount of time or providing an hour of discussion to educate someone. You actually have two parties who are in conflict. And in that situation, it is absolutely impossible to sit down at the very beginning of a case and know how much time that case is going to take. I have had cases that have taken 10 hours of my time, and I have had cases that have gone on for 2 years and took hundreds of hours. And you don't know that from the beginning, and the parties don't even know that from the beginning, because there are so many issues to work through in a divorce where there might be conflicts that you just don't anticipate. Chime in if you like, think of anything. Have you had many people asking about the flat fee divorces?
I think once somebody hears the term flat fee divorce or sees it advertised somewhere, it's obviously something that they're going to ask about whenever they consult with an attorney. If they've ever heard of it being a thing, then they're curious to know exactly what that means. And I think it's important to remember that you get what you pay for. Mm-hmm. So whenever, I'm not saying that there are not people in cases where a flat fee wouldn't be appropriate or wouldn't be a good idea. We don't do them here for divorces, largely because, like I said, you get what you pay for, and our product that we provide and our service that we provide our clients, we don't want to have to limit that to a certain number of hours or a certain level of care. But there are some attorneys out there who will take cases, who will do them on a flat fee basis. And I think that's okay sometimes if you have no children, if you have no real assets, no real debts that you're fighting over, if there's literally nothing, basically if you've been married for like 2 days, it might be okay to do a flat fee divorce. There are cases out there that are not complicated at all that you may be able to get a flat fee divorce for and get what you need out of it. But I think that in the long run, you're either going to end up paying too much for what you really needed, or you're going to end up not getting what you really needed out of the divorce. Yeah. And there's kind of no way to know until the divorce is done, and either you have an agreement that you are very happy with, but maybe you could have arrived at that cheaper even than a flat fee.
I feel like flat fee is almost kind of like cost sharing.
Yeah.
It means some clients are going to way overpay, and some clients might underpay, but the ones who are underpaying aren't getting the type of service that we could provide. And you kind of touched on a point that I have like underlined in my notes, is it's really important if you're looking into a flat fee to understand you are not paying less money for the same service. If that were the case, that means that there are lawyers out there who, out of the kindness of their hearts, are taking big pay cuts to provide this service, And those people are legal aid and
right.
working for the government. If you're going to a private law firm, these are business people. And what they're doing is, and there's nothing wrong with this, but either a flat fee, it's called a flat fee, but it's structured in a way where you pay by phase. So someone might say they're a flat fee divorce attorney, but they charge $3,000, but that includes for the filing of the initial complaint for divorce up to mediation or a temporary hearing. And then the next phase, they charge another amount. If you want your attorney to take a deposition, they say, okay, it's going to be a $3,000 flat fee.
It's more of an a la carte.
Exactly.
Than a flat fee.
And those attorneys are not making less money. They're just charging you in chunks rather than by the way a traditional firm bills. Other firms who are closer to a more traditional flat fee, they're going to not have the same type of customer service. It's going to be more of a factory approach where you're paying a fee and you're very limited on access, being able to ask questions, and how much time you have with your lawyer and
which for some people is fine.
Yeah.
They don't need all that much hand-holding. It's not a complicated, every case is complicated, but you know, for some people that's fine.
Yeah.
For most, I think it's not.
Yeah, and at Atlanta Divorce Law Group, we're very focused on customer service, and we would not be able to provide the type of service to our clients if we took flat fee cases. We have a team approach, so if I'm in court, we have other associates who, if my client calls and has a crisis, someone's going to be here to help. We have a concierge divorce advocate who can help clients with non-legal issues. We have status meetings and strategy meetings and update calls. And these are things that a flat fee attorney just is not able to provide.
Or they will, but they'll charge extra for it.
Exactly. And so you're not really paying less for the same service. My feelings about something closer to a true flat fee is, you know, if you're going through a medical crisis, if you have cancer and you're needing surgery and chemotherapy, you are not going to want to go to a treatment center that says, okay, you have surgery, you can't ask many questions, here you go, and now you're out the door. You're going to want to go to the place where you might pay for some more appointments, but that's available to you, and you can ask as many questions, and you might want your handhold and a lot of questions answered. The same is true for a family crisis. Anyone who has a big family legal issue, it's a family crisis. And my opinion is, just it's not typically it's not a good idea to cut corners in who you choose to walk through a family crisis with you.
Yeah, regardless of how difficult or simple you think your case is, in the reality, it might feel like, well, we agree on everything, and that's wonderful, and we always want our clients to agree to as much as they can with their former spouses, but even if you agree to everything, you may not be thinking of everything that's going to come up. So it's really important to have guidance from somebody who's going to take the time, going to be able to take the time to really focus on your case and all the intricacies of it, and make sure that no stone is going unturned, and that when you're done with your divorce or your case, you have an order or settlement agreement that covers everything you need it to cover, and you don't have to go back later and spend more money fixing something that should have been done correctly in the first place.
And that's something we see a lot. Someone comes to us after they already have a final order and it just was rushed or not done well.
They didn't get their own attorney.
Yes, and then more money was spent.
Forever. Yeah.
And you know, the final point I would like to make is that going to a firm that does not do flat fees does not mean you're going to be bleeding money. We want to sit down with clients and talk about how to minimize your attorney's fees. And the great thing about the way that we bill is we're able to customize our strategies to meet the client's goals. So in our initial strategy session, your attorney will talk about what are your goals. And if one of the big goals is minimizing legal fees, we talk about how do we meet your other goals and achieve those while minimizing fees, and we come up with a plan for that. So I don't want anyone to think that you're choosing between something, you know, inexpensive or more controllable. There are ways to control fees and minimize fees, even with a traditional billing system.
And I think that there's, you know, that's a really good point. It's much easier to control how much you're spending on your divorce when you're paying for the time that's actually spent on it and not just a flat fee for each stage, like you said,
yeah,
or for the entire process.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for tuning in, and I hope this cleared up some of the questions and misconceptions about flat fee family law. Thank you so much, and have a great weekend.